Hi everybody, today we are going to model a gold chain which comes like bracelet, so which is can be designed using the curved circles. So I will guide you how to do that and how to do the download the material, gold material from the free library. Today I am going to guide you. Let's go into the video. After opening Blender, you can go to General. So before that, you can check it out. Here it's in centimeter in this unit. Okay. After that, please go to the Edit and Preference. Here search, type a kit. So it comes Blender Kit Online Asset Library. Kindly tick that options. Once it's ticked, so you should have an internet to access the materials. Here I have select find material and I search for gold and I press enter. So we have to wait till the material arrives. So here you can see that several material has been arrived with the gold. So this is one type of gold, this is one type of gold, this is one type, this is one type. So like this, different kind of gold material is available, so we can use for the material. So kindly disable this point. After that, press Shift A on the keyboard and create a curve and circle. Press G and Y to move towards, and you can move it here. Again, create Shift A and create a circle. And you can add one more some object which is additional reference. So you can type here, you can search for node, N-O-D-E. Here it comes WAG node. You have to tick these three icons. So for advanced node designing, and you have to go for type extra. So it comes extra object, add extra curve and extra mask. So which will be added in the list, I will show you in the minute. Okay, now I show you, press Shift A. Go to curve. Before you are seeing only these materials here, it has created so many curve material which is required for us, and even in the mess also it will be having additional list. Okay, after creating that, select this circle, press 7 on the keyboard, press period key to zoom, press tab on the keyboard, so you can able to see the curve editing options. Select this one, press R to rotate in X axis, press X key, type 60, enter. Select this vertex, type, press R on the keyboard, Y axis 60 and enter. Select this one, press R to rotate, and X2 in X axis, type minus 60 and click here, rotate in Y axis, pressing Y, R and Y, and minus 60. So now the rotation happened done. So I press N on the keyboard. I just enable the shortcuts to understand for easily. Okay, now go to object mode. Now you can able to see some design of this. So we are going to give bevel for this. Before that, save the file. I just save it as in desktop as tutorial. Save the file. Okay, now go to this green editing option, which is that is object data property. Go to data product property. Here go to geometry, and here is the beveling is there depth. So start creating the beveling tool. Okay, now I just make it reduce it a little bit. Okay, I already can share smooth, and after that, okay, this is let it be. Then after creating this, we can go to the object, convert to mesh from curve. So now it's converted to mesh from curve. So now here we can take the auto normal and shared smooth. Okay, here what we are going to do is we are going to give shared smooth plus control 1 to make it a smooth surface. Here you can go to the modifier, it's apply the subdivision modifier for the same. So there's a shortcut of control 1. So now this is created. After this, press 1 on the keyboard. Press, yeah, this looks fine. So let me design this model. Okay, after this, select this curve. So I think we need to increase a little bit more, I think, for this bevel. So what I'm going to do is I press Ctrl Z and go to the existing settings here, bevel option. Okay, I just increase the bevel. Okay. Now it looks better. Okay, after that I save it and again go to this object and convert to mesh from curve. And go to the normal auto smooth, press control 1 to smooth it. Okay, fine. So now what I'm going to do is press 7 on the keyboard and press shift D and X axis, you can move like this. So I just move very closely GX. I press shift key to move slowly. Okay, now this chain has been created. So what I'm going to do is we are going to continue this. For this we are going to apply a array modifier. Go to add modifier, type array, and you can here you can reduce this size. So I just make it zoom and I just set it to be a little bit, yeah, this looks fine, correct? Okay, now after do that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to increase the count. So now I have increased the count, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to, using this curve, I'm going to make it round of that chain. Okay, I just G and I move it. So after that, I'm going to align the same G, Z and move towards here. Okay, select this object, then go to the again add modifier and type curve. In this curve, select these tool object and select this one. Now it's selected. So just drag and move this, I just move it a little bit further. Just make it go top and well, that's not good. Okay, it be here and I type minus X. So now we can see it's came above that. Okay, I have noticed why it's happened. Only this is single. I press Ctrl Z and I go to the same. I select this, I'll just select this and press Ctrl J to join. Oops. Okay, I do one thing. I close this one. I close the array. Okay. I select this and press Ctrl J to join. I save it. Now I apply the array again and I reduce. Yeah, it looks fine. Then again I add the array modifier and I added one more array, not required, which is we require this curve. And I go back, I select this and select this circle and I type x-axis. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to scale it down a little bit. Okay, and I'm going to scale this up tightly a little bit. Okay, I make it this much size. I select this one. I will add a count for the same. Where is the count? Array count, array count. Yeah, here is that. So I just increase it. Yeah, now it's came one more extra. So what I will do, I will just scale it out. So I reduce the scaling. Okay. And I go to the again array modifier. And here you can see it's one more design it's coming, but it's not look good. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to reduce the count once again. And I connect it. 18. So it's become a little bit fishy. I express a scale. I scale that circle to match this issue. Okay, now it's clear. So after that, I just select these two and I create shift D to duplicate and right click to cancel. Press M to move to the new collection. Type a new collection. Save it as backup. BKB. Then after do that, you can unselect this and select this one. Go to object, convert to mesh from curve. So now it's converted as mesh. Select this object, go to object, set origin to the geometry, press Ctrl S to save and Ctrl A to apply the scaling and rotation, press Shift C to zoom. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to delete this circle which is not required further and press Shift A and create a plane. So I scale it up and I feel this is very big, I feel, so I just scale it down. I press G and I press this one, I press dot. Okay, and after that you can move towards here to the bottom. G, Z and shift. Okay, fine. Okay, after do that, so what I'm going to go to object mode and press 2 on the keyboard and select these plus E2, X2 and Z to go up and go to tab and shift D and Z to move towards up and rotate X. On 80 and GZ, and I can make it a little bit further. And what I'm going to do is now go to the new material, apply new and select the emission. So emission, let it be 5. Okay, after that you can apply the material for this chain. Okay, before that I add a camera. After adding camera, press Ctrl Alt 0 to assign a camera as what, how it's required for us. Press N on the keyboard, go to view, lock the camera view and you can move how it's required to be found for you, which will be nice. So I just make it like this. Okay, after that I just unlock the camera view and close the menu. Then after that we can apply the material for this. Again, open this and drag this one. So I'm applying the material, it's downloading from internet. You can able to see that green color icon. So that is the downloading level. So now I go to render view. Before that, go to this option and select cycles. Okay, then after that here you can able to see, just a second, Yeah, here is the denoising. You can take that, which is under view layer properties. You can take that denoising for rendering the view. So after that, press Ctrl Z and go to the render option. Oops, it's applied wrongly. That green color, actually that golden color. So welcome back. Rendering has been completed, so it looks like real gold. Fine, it was very nice. I think I feel like, so what do you feel like in your give it in the comment box, and which model need to do the design, show you the tutorial step by step, give it in comment. So I will do the same tutorial next time. And before that, if you like your video, give a like button and share with your friends, so let they also learn more about modeling, and let they everybody go into 3D modeling and games, VFX, everything, let they join. So we have to start developing the model from a small material, which we need to give a 100% accuracy. So that is our goal always. Okay, now don't forget to subscribe the channel. If you're new to the channel, subscribe the channel, so you will get all the new videos related to modeling and gameplay and computer technical supports. Like that, many videos will be coming now soon. So next video which I'm going to do is how to disable the Windows 10 update permanently. So next video is I'm going to put the same. Subscribe the channel. Bye.